Americans, which I'll return to in a moment, overwhelmingly favor a two-state settlement on the June 67 border. What you can say in general about American support for Israel, it's very clear when you are sort of out there, the support may be broad, but it's not very deep. What does that mean in practical terms? So, for example, if a newspaper writes a critical article about Israel, whether it's The Times, The Washington Post, The LA Times, and there'll be letters written in objecting to the article, it's always the case that the letters are only signed by Jews. You're never going to see, apart from the Christian fundamentalists, which I'll leave aside for a moment, but mainstream people are not going to any longer rise to Israel's defense. A 2007 Anti-Defamation League poll found that American support for Israel is much less than for, say, the United Kingdom or Japan. It falls basically within the area of India and Mexico. Now, if you consider what kind of press Mexico and Mexicans are getting, again, it's a significant decline for Israel's standing in the United States. The most interesting poll findings are among American Jews. There you find, to quote one survey from 2005, the attachment of American Jews to Israel has weakened measurably in the last few years, continuing a long-term trend. American Jews care less, talk less, and act pro-Israel less than ever before. The main pollster is a fellow named Stephen Cohn. He seems to have devoted his life to polling Jews in every imaginable topic. I can barely imagine a more dull topic, or more dull life endeavor. He writes that in the long run, a polarization of American Jewry is likely. A small group of pious Jews will grow more pious and attached to Israel, while the larger group of Jews will drift away. And then some of the findings are actually kind of astonishing. They were, at any rate, to me. 2006, they ask, how close do you feel to Israel? Among Jews under 40, one-third said distant. And then a 2007 poll was asked, if Israel were destroyed, would you feel it as a personal tragedy? Now, I think it'll come as a surprise to many of you when they were asked, Jews under 35, would Israel's destruction be a personal tragedy for you? Less than half said yes, which was very surprising. I found myself in an unusual place because personally, I would find it a tragedy. I think the destruction of any culture or any country is a tragedy. And I probably would be personally appalled by it. But among the under 35 generation, there's been obviously a there are different ways to interpret it, your generation, you know. I think most of what goes on in Israel, deserves, the whole country deserves an Oscar because it's just one big show. It's all theater. It's all, it's Cecil B. DeMille writ large, and Cecil B. DeMille was already large. You take these things like the Gaza withdrawal, and there's all of this drama and people are tearing their hearts out and they're anguished and fighting with the army. It was all sheer nonsense. It was just made for television melodramatics. The Gaza withdrawal could have been done without one tear being shed, one altercation with one soldier. There are 8,000, 6,000, 8,000 settlers in Gaza. There are 2 million Palestinians, Hamas, crazy. All you had to do was tell the Gaza settlers, hey folks, we're pulling out our troops next week. If you want to stay, stay. They'd be out of there very fast. It was all theater. Israel is just, Israel is a country made for TV. It's just a theater.